without using the word fuck.
Right. What should go here?
I've been toying with the phrase exploded out of their snatch.
Oh, yeah? Do you think that resonates with the youth of today? With the crowd of now?
I think it's evocative.
Oh, yeah? Do you think that resonates with the youth of today?
It's on stream. We can say fuck
as much as we want to. Hey, chat.
Oh, crap. I forgot to mute the stream again. Hello, everyone. Just on YouTube at this point, I think, because I think Twitch has stopped letting you dual stream.
Yeah, we're waiting them out as they don't want us playing with the other kids. So right now it's just going to be YouTube.
Well, that's handy. I can just open the YouTube chat then.
Yeah, there we go.
I'm Yartza Grosjean. Welcome to the Post-CP stream. I'm joined by Frost.
It is me.
And we're playing a bit of the old Amnesia the Bunker. Have you played this one?
Good old Amnesia. I've not played an Amnesia since the first one. And wasn't it a mod to begin with?
What, this game or the original?
The original. The first Amnesia. The first time we forgot everything.
I wouldn't think so. Because it was Frictional were established. They'd made a couple of games in the Penumbra series before Amnesia. Amnesia had a very similar engine.
Yeah. It was a lot of Penumbra and then into Amnesia. See, that was my generation of the PewDiePies, the Markipliers, all those content creators that weren't you.
Oh, yes. Amnesia was like one of the earliest stream bait games.
Yep, absolutely. Of watching other people play games and scream. Yeah.
There you go. Thanks for the $5, E1 Crazy for Life, who says, at the current rate of the trend with Amnesia games, do you think a future installment will make it onto one of your worst games lists? Well, it's kind of gone up and down, E1 Crazy for Life. I mean, they've all got their own foibles. First one's really good. Second one I didn't like because it was more of a walking sim. Third one had some very specific issues. This one's actually quite good again, but got also some new issues of its own.
There you go.
So it's all over the place.
I mean, like, if they were to continue doing the same thing over and over again, it couldn't see your worst games list, could it? Blandest, maybe, but not sure not worst.
Well, depends how bad it gets, I suppose.
Outdated at worst, I'd say.
Maybe. Well, it's already pretty outdated.
Yeah.
I mean, you only have to look at it. Fungus Finder gives $2 and says, Yahtzee, that French in today's EP was exquisite. Thank you, I was practicing.
Oh, yeah? You're running off to France? You're vacationing?
No, I just studied French for a while, and I just like speaking in French.
Oh, lovely. Yeah.
The French phrase I used in today's EP, I got from Google Translate, though. That wasn't actually my skill with French on display.
But the accent's all you, yeah?
Yeah.
From that, was it Ferrero Rocher commercial?
Oh, monsieur, is this Rocher? You are really spoiling us.
What a good old time. Yeah, I took about 3 years in high school. Not much stuck.
Wow. What was the line from today's review? Mon Dieu, pourquoi est-ce que je ne prends jamais?
This is my God, I am not... What was it?
My God, why do I never sodding learn?
There you go. Oh my goodness, you were not kidding about the outdated look. Wow.
Whoa.
That is beautiful. This is full release, yeah? We're not doing another early access, are we?
No, this is it.
Wow. That's beautiful.
Like I said when I reviewed Rebirth, it felt like they're still using the engine from the first game.
This
and
is
in a way, that's sort of admirable, I suppose.
Yeah. Why? For loyalty as a trait? Is that...
Maybe it's like me with Game Maker Studio. It's not strictly the best tool to use, but we can't be bothered to learn a new one.
Fair. As long as they're pushing the medium, maybe. But this...
Yeah. As long as they're doing new things with it.
That's right. And this one caught me because you said we are, as you can see, in the war as Frenchmen.
The first big one.
The first big one? Okay.
Yes.
Love it. I do love that whole... There's a lot of shit B-tier horror movies that go, we're in a war, but you know what's worse than a war? Something paranormal in the middle of this war.
Oh, that's a whole genre in itself, isn't it? What was that movie with Billy Elliot in it?
The one with the tank? No?
It was in like, they were in like a World War One trench and the Nazis were all zombies or something.
Yeah, yeah, something like that.
I guess they wouldn't have been Nazis.
They would have just been
Germans.
Germans, yeah.
Yeah.
There we go, a scavenger with the $5. Comment about the game being 4 hours jumped out at me. Does this mean your kids see your face more, or is it a brief respite from massive games?
No. Jesus fucking thing. Sorry, I'm just messing with this thing.
He's immersed.
Well, I wouldn't say much of this game feels like a respite from anything.
I think more so like when you have a short game like this, do you go ahead and just keep on going to the next game, or do you like take a breather?
I just like to, you know, have an afternoon off.
Yeah.
Okay. Mess around with things, work on Star Trek Vagabond a bit.
There you go. So you reinvest that time into yourself.
Yeah.
It was a game ever so short that you kind of went back and gave it maybe like a half another playthrough.
Maybe. No specific examples spring to mind. I think back when I had more time, if I was playing a game like Infamous 2, I'd try to run through it twice.
Yeah.
Oh, I don't really have the time for that sort of thing these days.
This journalistic integrity of yours. What's this? Chaos Chris, member for 36 months, early access. Thank you. Double deep dialogue day. Ooh. In reference to what? And then Victor with a good questionnaire. Top three must play bad games of the year, Yachts. Must play bad games. You've got to see this.
Well, there's certainly been no shortage of bad games.
Yeah.
I guess if you're interested in learning how not to do it, Gollum would probably be a good start.
Well, yeah, it's an interesting walkabout, I say. Yeah. Are we back in 2011? Why is it all brown? No, this is 1910, my friend. During the war, everything was brown.
Oh, I just forgot what I'm supposed to do.
Man, this is like bringing me back to the first time I played DayZ and the like. Wow. Interesting. AV Ricochet, $5. Yahtzee, any possibility of a new Dashford Pierce Jacques McCowan novel in the near future? I need another audiobook with your dulcet voice.
Yes, it's going to be my next one. And if the first draft's done, it's with the editor.
And our highest donator gets their name in the book. Name like a can of soup after him.
Sure.
Amir Yasser, 10 currency. To both of you, what are all of your dream games? What are all of your dream games?
I don't know.
I see. Well, you already reviewed your dream game. Doom. Fucking Duke Nukem 4.
Yeah, sure.
There you go. That's his dream game. Just go watch that again. And for mine, you know, something that takes the dog out for a walk in the morning, so I don't have to. That's my dream game.
You know, cooks me breakfast.
Yeah, there you go. Basically just like my girlfriend, but with maybe Tetris or a Bejeweled attached, something like that. Fungus Finder, $2. Forget Starstruck. Where the hell is Hatfall 2?
You'll probably not happen at this point. Sorry.
You're not a sequel developer? No? You move on?
No, I was working on it for a while, but just didn't work out. Oh, I'm getting gassed up. Yes, a gun in an Amnesia game, Pacific Blue.
Yeah.
You even fire it like twice.
Weapons in horror games. I don't know how I feel about these. Yeah, yeah. See, I had a question and I didn't want to blow my load right before the stream. It's been 3 years since Design Delve, and I know your fans think that you invented the sun, the moon, and the stars, but do you ever see a game and it makes you go, huh, I think I recognize that concept? I think I know where that's coming from.
Don't think so.
Yeah, because I found a game called Call Hating is similar in spirit to Hold the Phone. With the nonsense of the premise is they're trying to get the internet back on, but they have to use an old phone and get through all that malarkey going on there. Doesn't much have that anxiety of like, oh god, what if I'm not near the phone when somebody needs me to answer something, but very, very much in that same bizarre premise.
Well, I'm sure there's been other sort of bureaucracy maps.
Right. It'll be the trend. Serial cleaners, that could be a thing, maybe.
Well, that was a thing before I made my cleaner game.
Alright. Given development cycles, we should start seeing some Yahtzee likes, no?
I think you overestimate my influence on the industry generally. Now, there was a game that someone sent us a code for recently that was where they said that they'd watched Dev Diary avidly and felt very motivated by it. Then I'm going to get you out of here.
And what was the game?
Hang on, I got it on my list somewhere.
Oh, okay. No, Michael, I don't remember a minigame called Where's Dildo?
Yes, I'm sure I'd remember that.
Oof.
I'll get you back to safety. Just hold on. Oh, here we go. It's a game called Merchant of the Six Kingdoms.
Merchant of the Six Kingdoms.
Yeah. And the guy who made it sent me an email with a code for it, saying that it's a good that my Dev Diary series got him through countless design problems. Well, there you go. I just checked the email.
I change it. This is my dream game. Yeah. I played an old Flash game like this. It was just nothing but bartering.
Yeah, I played it for a bit. It wasn't really my speed. But it's nice to know I had some influence.
There you go. And that one that made a game after Trilby. What was it? Like that thief one?
Yeah. Yeah. Felcher. Felcher.
Very naughty.
Schnell means quickly.
Yeah.
In German.
Yeah. So we're in a war. We're helping someone so far.
Yeah, World War One. Yeah. We're helping our colleague. And we just got hit by a big bomb.
As you do. That's how these things start. In the bunker.
In the titular bunker. Who knows how much time has passed since we got knocked out?
3 days. Scavenger with the $5. Not game related, but it really changes the brother in the first Mummy movie if you realize he served in World War One. Suddenly his nihilism makes sense.
I don't remember that being mentioned. Wasn't that the guy played by that Scottish actor who was in Four Weddings and a Funeral?
Was he in Four Weddings and a Funeral?
I seem to remember it. Could be wrong. I think he's just one of them British actors that just show up in the things.
Right. Well, you're right. He is Scottish, yeah. It's John Hannah is his name.
That's it.
Yeah. Oh, he were. Yep, Four Weddings and a Funeral is Matthew.
Aha.
Good on you. So when Slender Man show up? Yeah, does it continue on with the staple gameplay of wander around, try not to get grabbed by Big Ugly?
Yeah, but it's sort of like the previous Amnesia games would have these occasional little organic moments when you just had to creep around like a set of rooms or some corridors, but that's like that. This is like that, but stretched out to the whole game.
Right.
The whole game is an organically designed, open-ended, one of those situations. Right.
But you are French now, so you are creeping around, yeah?
Ha ha! Ho ho
ho! What if you had a survival horror game where you had to outrun monstrous versions of Kaiser Wilhelm II and Otto von Bismarck? I feel like Call of Duty Zombies.
Yeah, I was just about to say, isn't that what Call of Duty Zombies was?
Yeah.
So this is our only flashlight, and to use it, we have to pull the cord, and it makes a hell of a lot of noise.
Is that real? Is that like an actual thing that was a thing?
I used to have like a flashlight when I was a kid that had like a little generator in it that you powered by squeezing the handle over and over again.
Wow.
And it didn't run for very long, but it worked.
Right. Yeah, yeah. So I've seen modern flashlights that you shake them and they do that. I didn't know they had these back then. My God. Yeah,
I've never seen one with a pull cord, but that's all the generator is just something that spins around very fast.
Yeah, exactly.
And however you make it spin, it can be used to generate electricity.
Make like a gas-powered flashlights back then. Magnum weight, $5. I've always been interested in a horror game set during war or in the immediate aftermath of a war, especially World War One, where modern tech outpaced tactics. Well, there you go. So this is the game for you. World War One. Is there any other war horror games? Oh.
So there's that. Well, at least we got a gun.
Yeah, that's good.
At least we got a gun. And those two boxes of bullets we just picked up contained one bullet each.
One bullet each. Oh,
yes, I think I see a way the manufacturers of the bullets could have saved a couple of costs in a few areas.
That's enough to unalive yourself five times or so. This guy. Karuta Cowboy, 35 Zars. Did either of you play the Final Fantasy 16 demo? If so, what are your thoughts? I haven't felt this disconnected from the popular opinion since The Last of Us.
Ooh. No, I haven't played it. I've got other shit to play. I'm get through as much Diablo 4 as I can this week.
Oh, wow. You're reviewing that?
Well, that's bugger all else.
Fair.
For right now, anyway. And I'm going to play. I don't usually play demos for big games because I'm. Because what's the point? I'm going to be playing them anyway. It's my job.
Yeah. Even though I'm the demo guy, I have that exact same philosophy. If it's a big game, why am I going to if I'm definitely going to play the game?
Yeah, I don't need to be sold on this.
Yeah. That's this one. Diego Brando MTG, $10. Yahtzee, did you ever play any of Douglas Adams' adventure games? Been thinking about checking them out, but was unsure if they were supposed to be any good.
I've played a few of his. He did a text adventure called Bureaucracy. That's very funny. And he famously did a Hitchhiker's Guide text adventure, and he did a graphic adventure called Starship Titanic that I'd played for a while. The thing about Douglas Adams' adventure games was that they were all very, very difficult. They all had sort of like really hard to figure out moon logic running through them.
Oh.
And so like deliberately so. I think he got a kick out of it.
Right. So it's not just like, oh man, that's difficult, and more so like, oh, now you're just being difficult.
Yeah, this is just needlessly obtuse.
Right, fair enough.
And that was the whole point of Bureaucracy. That was one of the games that inspired Hold the Phone, incidentally. Because it's a game about having to navigate bureaucracy without dying of a heart attack and your blood pressure going up too high. So this is the safe room of the bunker. This is where we have to keep going back to between each expedition.
Okay, so this is your main. This is you're safe. This is your base. It's
yes,
like you're playing tag with the monster.
The monster can't get us in here.
Interesting.
And down here there is a generator. That powers all the lights in the bunker, but it's got it. The fuel will run out over time, and the monster becomes much bolder in the dark. Which is not to say you'll never run into it if you keep the lights on.
Right. Interesting. Remembering how you played Dredge, is it possible to not encounter the monster? Like almost.
I would say almost certainly no.
No,
I think there's a couple of moments where he's scripted to. Usually after you like do like a plot thing.
Nice. And can you go to any area in any order or?
Yeah, but there's a specific order you have to go in to like complete the sequence of events that will. Complete the game, as it were.
Yeah, look at that, open world. No.
And there's a couple of like fixed moments. Some doors require a very specific inventory item to open. Usually a key. Sometimes there'll be a door locked with a chain and you need to use a set of bolt cutters.
I like it.
But if it's a wooden door, you can bash or blow it open with anything that can generate enough force.
You mentioned loose bricks. Is that a common occurrence? And
yes. Although loose bricks, once you realize how useful they are, you notice that they're actually quite rare. Because we did it in the tutorial. You just fling it at a door, at a wooden door twice, and it just bashes it open.
Jesus, huh? Yeah. Do anything, I guess. What these now? Vince Julius, $5. Franz, ¿cómo fue su primera experiencia de los videojuegos cuando llegó a los Estados Unidos? Estoy tratando de practicar mi español. For those of you who don't speak Spanish, what was your first experience like playing video games when you came to the States? My first game played was Mario, because Mexico had a huge Nintendo culture because one of our favorite comedians was doing their best to put video games into the culture, and they loved Nintendo.
Huh.
Yeah.
That's cool.
So that's it's big part of my culture, especially the part of the culture that immigrated into the States. That's why I think the Mario movie is doing so well and why the Link movie will probably bomb.
Well, you heard it here first.
There you go. That's on me. How was your grammar? It was pretty good. Yeah. It's very formal, you know. I always say, once you've mastered a language, you butcher it. Then that just shows just how much you've mastered it. So the formality is what gives you away if it's trying to sound natural.
My attitude.
Yeah. Like in Breaking Bad, Better Call Saul, they're all gangsters, they're all thugs, but they speak incredibly formal. Learned in Spain. Oh yeah, if you got Spain Spanish, then yeah, because they still use vosotros. That's you don't see those, but in the Bible. Yeah,
okay, guess we better go out into the bunker and start solving puzzles and things. Oh, let me just double check that everything's squared away nicely.
Now, be honest, I won't judge you. Did it spook you? Did the game spook you at all?
Yeah, I found this game pretty spooky.
Even on this playthrough?
Yeah, because there's a lot of stakes. Because the safe room is the only place with a save point.
Right.
If you get eaten by the monster, you have to start all over again, and you know. So you really want to avoid that.
I admire your honesty. Oh yeah, tell us about the inventory space. And
this is it. You get 6 spots. Although you pick up like pouches that adds 1 inventory space.
That's good.
And you've got a. I think you might have seen it earlier. You get a storage box in the safe room that can hold an additional 9 things.
Mm.
Though I found if you just dump fuel canisters on the floor of the generator room, they'll stay there. So
yeah, and I'll just get around that.
Yes, yeah, so you don't really need the limited storage box. Oh, tell a lie. There's 16 spaces in there.
Ooh, look at that nice little grid function for you.
The pocket watch shows you how much time you have before the generator runs out, but I think for the first part of the game, where we have to go to the officer's quarters, I'm going to run the risk of doing it without the lights on, just to save on fuel.
Alrighty. And maybe we get a chance to see the monster.
Well, not for very long before I turn tail and flee.
That works too, well. Hola, Frost. Saludos desde Monterrey. Desde Monterrey.
Are you just all showing off now?
Oh, no, they're Mexican. That's not showing off. It's camaraderie. Mexican, Spain, Peru, Colombia, all of it. They all speak the same language.
Well, Brazil doesn't.
Yeah. I find talking to Brazil is strange because you hear all, like, the phonetics make sense. But none of it's registering. You feel like you're stroking out.
Hmm.
Yeah, and almost the same with Tagalog, which is what they speak in the Philippines, which is like a mixture of Spanish and I think it's Chinese influenced. And so you hear words that definitely make sense, and then the next one you're like, whoa, that was not me.
Isn't it funny often like the language of a country between two other countries with large dominant languages always tends to be a language that's sort of in between the two?
Yeah. Amazing.
I guess it makes sense, but it's always fun to see it happen.
I do find language and accents interesting, and the way that the American accent is rumored to essentially be if you had taken someone from England in the 1600s and stuck them in the woods, and their accent never changed.
Huh.
Yeah.
But which American accent are you talking about there?
I imagine they mean like rural, southern, like the country folk.
Y'all.
Y'all, yeah. That's closer to actually English.
Uh-huh.
And this guy here. Fungus Finder, $5. Also, one, you missed an opportunity to use Dory from Adventures Nigh in today's video. Two, bought all your books online, trying to read more, so thanks. There you go.
Okay.
Do your books have pictures in them?
On the front.
Oh, well, and I can't read them then.
Some of them have a photo of me on, like, the last page.
There you go. Dusk has fallen and still, of course. Have you considered a pop-up book, Mo?
I asked the sergeant. He shrugged, as if I was asking about when it might next rain.
Well, having really bought a few of those for my kids, I'm not sure I'd want to make something so ephemeral. Because they tear those motherfuckers apart.
Yeah, that's fair, if you are that attached to it. But that's a market in itself. What are those? There's those books that you're meant to destroy them, and it's supposed to be, like, stress-relieving and cathartic.
You mean adult coloring books?
Maybe. Rex's Journal is what it's called.
So one of the gimmicks of this game is that it sort of procedural generates some aspects of it.
Right.
Like the contents of these lockers tend to alter.
Alright.
And you have to find the locker codes for each dead person.
Hmm. Alright.
Oh, here's one. 6071, Mr. Travers.
Oh, yeah. It's a bit like
Thief.
Thanks,
Mr. Travers.
It's like Thief, I think, was second level or so. Let's move around the name. And John Connor with the 550 Canadian. Do you think there are any game genres that elicit a stronger emotion than a good horror game? They seem unique in that respect. A stronger emotion.
Two grenades. It's not of much use. Well, I think the emotions I felt towards something like Spiritfarer were a lot stronger than I feel towards horror games.
Right. You like crying more than screaming?
I think crying is probably a more cathartic emotional experience than, the creeping dread.
That's fair, yeah. It's like Five Nights at Freddy's, right? It's just nothing but pure anxiety and tension.
I can't deal with that.
Yeah.
I'm anxious enough already. I'm back on Lexapro. Yeah. I'm getting the Lexapro shivers.
Oh, yeah. Oh, no. I don't know. I find those, like, jump scare things as a sort of, if you go to a stand-ups and the comedian just jumps down and starts tickling you.
Yeah.
And it's like, I made you laugh. It's like, yeah, but that was not funny.
Yeah, I equate them to fart jokes. Oh, they can, like, make you laugh in the moment, but if you want us to stick around, you're going to need more than that.
There you go. See, now they're showing off the Lexapro camaraderie. There you go.
I think it's a fairly common anti-anxiety stroke, antidepressant.
You want to have a good shiver time, take Lexapro, Adderall, and lithium at the same time. Oh, I figure he wants less of them.
Won't be doing that. Okay.
Oh, this is interesting. General question for Austin Yahtzee. Is it healthy to play a horror game at least once a month?
I wouldn't say regimen? Healthy. All right.
Sure, I suppose. I don't know. Like, getting yourself to feel that kind of extreme emotion, I think it's only cathartic with the release. If you have nowhere to put it, I think it's just going to be a mess.
So you can craft Molotovs with empty bottles and fuel, but I don't have a lighter with which to light the Molotov.
If you use the grenade...
I think there's a lighter in one of the lockers, but I need to find the codes.
Right.
And grenades are very, very noisy. And no prizes for guessing what the best way to attract the monster to your position is.
Do they have any other use aside from just going, hey, I'm here?
Well, I can blow open doors.
But you can brick doors too. Said you could brick.
But as I say, bricks are a lot harder to find than grenades, weirdly.
Right. Wow.
Yeah, I mean, I had grenades for days by the end of my run through of this. I was like, I'm not using this. I'm not stupid.
Amazing. Wonder how many games Frost wishlisted after all these showcase streams. Funny enough, I had most of the ones I was interested in before then. Before the showcases.
Annoyingly, you can't carry a map with you. You just have to look at the map in the safe room and just try to commit it to memory.
Weird.
Alright, so this lad's telling us that if we want to get into the arsenal where the dynamite is that we can use to blow up the exit, we have to go to the communications room in the soldiers' quarters. Can do, Sergeant Stefan Joubert.
Why does your fella put his hand up every time you're reading?
Because that's how you gauge your health.
Oh.
The more blood there is on your hand, the lower your health, you see.
Oh, it's very diegetic. It's better,
it's better than a heart tattoo on a tit.
How will I know? Not bad.
Monster usually shows up by this point.
I'll just toss a grenade his way. Here we got Yats. So when are you going to review Street Fighter and will Frost be on the post ZP for that game? You're not playing that game too, are you?
Next week, as it happens.
Jesus, man.
The World Tour mode was recommended to me. And I rather enjoyed it, so I'm going to review the game.
Really? Oof.
Probably just the World Tour bit, though.
Right.
I mean, I still ain't no fighting game sweaty.
Yeah, that's fair. Yeah. Especially when you can just beat those games with, like, a fireball, why not? I mean, I just miss Mortal Kombat Deception, that sort of RPG story mode. If only. And then System Shock Remake after Street Fighter? Oh, man, you just...
I haven't really gone back to the System Shock Remake.
You're needed, though. Everyone wants to know what it's like from a veteran perspective and from someone who's never done it.
Okay. I tried it out. I wasn't really into it. Hope that helps.
There you go. There it is. Same as before.
Oh, stop bombing things, you silly Germans. That's a trap.
I'll go in there. That's Kate Blanchett's dressing room.
Yes, that would be very rude of me.
Yeah.
Is there another way in? I don't think there is.
Can you go through this spooky tunnel that thing came through?
No, you can't go in the tunnels that the monster uses.
Aww.
Now, you got to be very careful walking past those holes, because sometimes he's hiding just inside. You got to listen for his breathing and watch for the signs.
That's funny.
The one thing I do like about this game is that it doesn't have the thing that earlier Amnesia games had, where you lose sanity in the darkness.
Yeah, that felt like too much micromanagement, I feel.
Yeah, in fact, this game doesn't really have a sanity mechanic at all.
Yeah.
It has spent as much time in the darkness as you like. It's probably the only place you're guaranteed to be safe, as long as you don't move.
The thing is, though, like, what's more of a detriment to your insanity, being down here or being in the war?
Well, good question.
Maybe it's trying to say something.
This is a nice holiday from the war at this point.
Yeah, but this is a reprieve.
Thanks, J. Delisle. We've got another locker we can open.
Yeah. And you got Perro Alto with $7.99. Good morning, Yahtzee and Frost. Either of you tried the Final Fantasy 16 demo? The consensus was, we're going to try the game out anyways, so there's really no need to play the demo. Granted, they did say the demo will continue your progress. Does that impact anything?
Well, if I find myself with some time to kill because of the game I was reviewing the previous week finished earlier than I thought, maybe I'll make a start on it.
There you go. This will be the first Final Fantasy that I properly play, so I'm just trying to get my hands on the whole game.
Well, from the sounds of it, it's not really representative.
That's what I'm hoping for.
Because it's apparently it's going to be full-on real-time combat now. They've officially given up on turn-based JRPG-style combat.
Good. That's what XCOM's for in Civ.
Or the Persona games.
Oh, those, yeah. I need to start one of those at some point. I feel it's my duty.
Shotgun shells. And another bloody grenade.
Yay. Look at us go. yes, that is a fan light. Yeah, he just cranks her. Look at him.
Yeah.
Just cranks her up and lights away.
You know, I really feel like the monster would have shown up by now.
I think so too. Maybe he's stuck.
Help. Little help.
Yeah.
Okay, we're going to need a brick for that one.
Well,
or a grenade.
Or an explosive barrel we could shoot.
Well, you said bullets are almost more valuable than the grenades.
Jesus, man. Okay, so the grenades are dime a dozen, and then the bullets are a little bit better. But yeah, the bricks are still the most valuable.
Pretty much.
All right.
All right, well, we've got a code for one of the lockers. Uh-oh, shit.
Uh-oh. You've been naughty.
Aha. Oh, this one doesn't have a code on it.
Oh, that's unfortunate.
Fuck you, P. Corsi. I hope it hurt.
Oh, rude. This is funny. It feels like we're playing... It's like a very twisted take on Pac-Man.
You know what? That very thought crossed my mind.
Amazing.
Like, this is basically full-on 3D Pac-Man.
Yeah. Amazing. I think I was reminded of this because Code Bullet, he just likes to do a bunch of coding stuff. And the most recent thing he made was 3D VR Pac-Man. So... Reminded me of this.
God, that sounded close. Don't kill me.
Just because you asked so nicely, you know.
This corridor's still full of gas. Stop being full of gas.
Where's your mask?
I don't have one.
Oh.
I think there's one in one of the lockers.
What we got here? Camden Ninja with the $5. System Shock Remake made me think, what are some other games now dead, forgotten, but are still influential and fundamental to modern gaming? Deus Ex. So you're saying like your immersive sims?
Yeah.
Mario. You know, whatever, like the staple of any genre, I think, is always worth studying. Half-Life, still, yeah.
I want to go into Blanchett's room, but it teases me.
The point was dead and or forgotten. I wonder if there's a game. Pac-Man to VR and you play as one of the ghosts. No, you're the Pac-Man.
That's what you'd call the... many years after the fact, remake sequel of the original Pac-Man.
This is the Pac-Man.
Yeah, the Pac-Man.
I sure hope so. Oh, man. This monster doesn't care for you, man.
Yeah, I'm feeling a little left out.
Right?
Delisle. There you go. And you've got the wheel, you sly bastard.
Ooh, just like I must put my wheel in my locker. What?
8201. Well, that wheel is very sentimental to him.
Yeah, this was my grandmother's.
Oh, bugger!
Okay, the inventory strikes back.
Well, lucky we're quite close to the safe room.
Mm-hmm. Harry's a very open. Is it always run back to base, or can you actually hide? You say creep around, but there's nothing to hide if you get caught.
You can crouch and like. It's more about not making sound than it is about hiding.
Yeah. I was a scavenger with the $2. Help, step monster, I'm stuck. Ah, porn's rotted another mind.
Hang on to the fuel canisters. Yeah.
Let me see here. At the Escapists, do you guys know the Twitch stream is not working? Let me catch you up to recent events. So, Jeff Bezos has been making some weird decisions, and he doesn't want anyone dual streaming. Dual streaming means that we are simultaneously streaming to two different sites at once. So we're sticking with the bigger one for now. No official statement as far as that is concerned, but for right now, the plan is to just be on YouTube. If they rescind it, we go back to Twitch. If not, I imagine that we don't.
Thanks, Jeff Bezos.
It's all his fault. Blame Jeff. First, he ruins the Lord of the Rings, and now he's ruining Twitch. Like, what's next?
Okay, save the game. What shall we do now?
Was it Bezos' decision directly? Don't quote me on that.
I guess I'm going to open that trapped door just in case there's something I need.
Yeah, show him the creepy thing. CEO of Amazon is Andy Jassy, not Bozo. It's always Jeff. He's behind it all.
And run!
Jesus, man.
Wasn't me.
It's just ding dong ditching him.
Wasn't me. I'm not here.
Yeah.
Yeah, he heard that.
Yeah. Now would be a horrible time to crank your light. Crank your torch. I forgot that's what you guys call them, torches.
Yeah. Crank your torch. Sounds like something else.
Yep. Scavenger $5. There was a debate in chat about the graphics. Would they be improved with more realistic graphics or stylistic like Valiant Hearts? Thoughts?
This game? Like,
yeah, this one.
Oh, wouldn't be very spooky if it was all cartoony like Valiant Hearts.
You say that, but there was that one horror game similar to this that did that old rubber hose Steamboat Willie style. Bit unnerving.
Bendy and the Ink Machine.
That's the one. Yeah, there you go.
Oh, you can hide. I'm going to hide under this bed. This bed that's like 2 foot above the ground.
Yeah, but, you know, he's got a stiff neck.
He'll never see me here.
Oh.
Fuel. I guess the game randomly decided it was only going to let me have a little bit of fuel for all that.
Just a little
on
bit.
On this occasion.
Yeah.
Oh, God, he's right. He's close enough to hear my flashlight. Now, here I am, just constantly pulling it like a complete prick.
Nope, just locked in your room, cranking your torch. as many prepubescent lads do. So this game is kind of-ish like Alien Isolation, but set during some wartime. You have some respect. This made the genre, kind of.
Sort of. Not really. First game did.
Yeah, Penumbra, more so.
That's where the monster is. It was hiding in his hole there. I will just quietly leave him to it.
As I crank away into the night.
Shit. I've usually found another brick by now. I want to open that locked wooden door.
Very minimalistic HUD elements, as they always have been. That's always fun. I'm sure my step monster comment was out of line. I didn't say it was out of line. Make of that what you will, because I recognize the comment. My brain's as rotted as yours. Speaking of World War One, Frost, what was the next kids game you and Amy were playing?
Sounds like a non sequitur to me.
Yeah, as they do. I think we're going to go back and just finish off some of the Humongous Entertainment games that we were missing. Outside of that, she had like Emperor's New Groove and a couple of other things too.
My kid loves Putt-Putt.
Really? Oh, that's good. It still holds.
My wife grew up with them, so she wanted to expose them to Putt-Putt.
So
if you wanted to play that fucking Topiary Creatures song like 9 times in a row, and you were playing Putt-Putt Saves the Zoo.
There you go. Oh, yeah, that's the first one. Quality. Putt-Putt Goes to Space, all that good stuff.
Didn't really latch on to Putt-Putt Goes to Space. It was all about the zoo for her. Okay. Now, I remembered what I was doing. I gotta get that wheel.
Daniel, with the hard questions here. Do you spend bricks to break open doors? Is there any in-game reason why you can't just hold on to the same brick to use on everything?
I think bricks break after a while.
Yeah. There's a... It's a very fragile bricks. That's not what I wanted.
Okay, got the wheel. Now we can open up the rest of the bunker.
Didn't Ron Gilbert work on Putt-Putt? Yes, he did almost all the Humongous Entertainment games. And your favorite, Return to Monkey Island.
Yes. And the original Monkey Island, don't forget.
Yeah.
Okay, so we've opened the prison. We don't particularly have a reason to go there right now. Maybe there's some stuff to pick up, but I've got quite enough on my plate.
Oh, see, look at that. So apparently these bricks do uphold to historical accuracy. Bad bricks were common back in the days. They mix sand or grass and such to be able to make more, but fragile bricks and scam people. Look at that. Immersive.
Okay. I guess we'll take one grenade just in case.
Do you think the team went to an actual bunker for inspiration, or they just this should be what it looks like?
I don't
know. A couple of Google pictures.
Then they'd have had to. I mean, somehow I doubt World War One bunkers would have been this big and complicated.
Right.
Although, what do I know?
Yeah, I wasn't there.
The button for dropping things.
What's here? Hey, Yahtzee, does the Monkey Island DLC have you interested at all to returning to Sea of Thieves?
No. As I said on Slightly Something Else the other day, it would feel like going to a themed restaurant for something you used to respect.
Oh, God, I love it. You really are like Anton Ego from Ratatouille. Even down in the hole, the other chef is starting to sell frozen microwave meals. With dignity.
Okay, soldiers' quarters. Soldiers' quarters. We needed to go to the soldiers' quarters next.
Yeah.
Which is just past mission storage. So I'm just going to turn the generator on. And then I have to start moving quickly.
Absolutely. Especially after you've, it is tradition that as you keep on progressing, it gets more agitated. Each crank might be your last. Oh, hey Yahtzee, have you taken your kids to Chuck E. Cheese yet?
No, probably a bit too young for that still.
That's not for children.
Well, Five Nights at Freddy's is really popular with the kids, isn't it? And that whole mascot horror thing.
Is it with the kids now? I thought it was people who were maybe 5 years younger than me, and I'm 28, so I don't know. It's because of that YouTube culture that they have around it.
Those YouTubers.
Yeah, those darn dirty YouTubers. My young niece and nephew love FNAF. Okay, it's found its audience. There you go. Lovely. 23 is the kids to me.
Okay, there's a map of the soldiers' quarters in there, which
nice.
If we can get in there, we can add it to the safe room map, but we need a brick. or similar.
Nice. So as you are making your way around this bunker, do things, as monster aside, do things get more dangerous? Any events, you know, more gas, anything?
Yeah, there's a couple of mix-ups. There's a bit where you have to explore some ancient ruins, and the monster's not there, but something else is.
Oh, God. My mother-in-law.
But for the most part, it's navigating these claustrophobic corridors, trying not to attract the horrible monster.
Lovely.
So we need the key for the communications room.
Oh, yeah. How do you save, says Purple Marauder.
Uh-oh. Shit. How do you save? You go to the safe room and click on the lantern.
Ooh. Oh, the gas.
Yeah, I'm gassed myself again. Uh-oh.
Refuses to wear his mask.
Oh, shit. I'm not here. None of us are here. Nobody's here at all. I don't know why you're looking over here, because there's obviously nothing here.
I don't see anything. Oh, God. This is tense.
I don't think it likes the gas either.
Yeah, that's good.
Though, for one bloody brick.
Did you ever start growing sympathetic to the monster? Like, name it?
No, maybe? I hate that bastard. Okay.
Bill the Monster, yeah. I forgot what PewDiePie used to call it.
Aha.
Hey, a brick.
Just what I needed.
Good quality brick.
See how long I can make it last.
Oh. Ration this brick. Yeah, is it blind? Like, what's the monster working with?
I guess it might be blind. I don't know. I've never had a really good look at it. Oh, bloody inventory.
Oh, it does already have a name, actually. Yeah, for those of you, or for you, I don't know if you've done your reading, what is the lore of Pol Amnesia?
Well,
it's an anthology.
Related to this game, I guess there's not much stuff that ties back to the previous games. Okay, communication key's in the barracks somewhere. I can't pick up anything else except this brick, apparently.
Ooh,
I'm just gonna hover it in front of my eyes with my telekinetic powers.
I get the feeling this was meant to be played in VR. Does it have a VR option?
I don't know. I don't think so. Hang on, I'll check.
Amazing. Does this new amnesia have the whole sanity mechanic? It does not.
No, it
does
not
at all. You just have a bloody hand.
Okay, we're looking for Quint's bed, I think it was.
Good old Jeff.
Larue. Picard.
First time Nicolai. In stream, weird seeing Yahtzee with a face, says Baked Beans. What an apt name. How long have you been streaming for?
Oh, like years now.
Yeah, but not nearly as long as you've been making videos.
Well, I guess not. I think I started around 2016 streaming.
All right. There you go.
Oh, letter to someone, sweetie.
Blue asking, so is this the second playthrough that you said you weren't going to do in the ZP?
It's That's the true stream. I need to. It's necessary.
Do you prefer, like, if you had your choice, stream after you've already done the thing and the review, or would you prefer it for the first time?
I guess I'm happy streaming after I've reviewed the game. Means I can talk everyone through all the stuff I found.
Yeah, it feels like I don't like saying things before my thoughts have settled. And I say a lot of stupid things because the thoughts take time to settle. People might mistake my reaction for my feelings.
Thought I saw a tripwire for a second there.
That's right, you've mentioned traps. What kind of traps are in this place?
It's mostly tripwires hooked up to either grenades or gas grenades or firebombs. Okay, well, the thing is, we need to get the communication device working. But there's no power here yet because all the switches are daisy chained. So we have to pull all the power switches in this area. Stop putting your flashlight away, you silly goose.
It's good dark in here. I don't like that at all.
I'm not sure I'm going to need a flare anytime soon unless I need to get rid of some rats.
Oh, you have to manage your rats too. Jesus.
Yeah, the rats are nasty.
Right, so there's rats, there's gas build up, the monster, there's tripwires. Anything else? Collapsing tunnels, maybe?
No, nothing like that.
All right.
Where's that brick? There it is.
Good
there
brick.
There was a door back here I wanted to smash.
Did you grow attached to the bricks? I know you said you don't like getting attached to inanimate objects.
Nah, they break after a few doors.
Tragic. It's like Gollum, my special brick.
My precious brick.
My precious.
Oh, hey guys. Don't mind me.
Jesus.
Now, those rats look particularly like 15 years ago standard 3D graphics.
Yeah.
Oh, lost the brick. And lost our lives in short order.
Well,
turns out that door was trapped. Silly.
Now
me.
We get to see what it's like to disarm it, yeah.
And lesson learned. Now this time we don't do that.
And have either of you played Mad Rat Dead?
Can't say I have.
Rhythm platformer on the Switch, I think. Interesting. Do we know whose bunker we're in? The signs are in French. I imagine this is the French?
Yeah. Yes, this is a French bunker.
French bunker. The Roman bunker, if only. Down we go. We descend into even more darkness.
Yeah. What's annoying now is that there's two games with the subtitle The Dark Descent now. And both of them have the first initial A.
Wait, what's the other one?
It's Aliens.
Oh. Wow, genre.
There's a new Aliens game called Aliens The Dark Descent.
Oh, and it's a squad-based shooter? Okay.
Those signs of traps.
Yeah, did those like super military games never appeal to you? I know a lot of fellas like that kind of stuff.
Not really.
No. Didn't have that group of friends that's like Tango Year 6 Bravo Charlie.
That's a tripwire. Boing.
Oh, God. I feel like that's going to get us later. Yeah, that's what I want, you know. Subvert your trope. We need the bright ascent now.
Now, where was that brick?
Are you fighting monsters in heaven?
Oh, free bandages. Didn't find that last time.
Well, you got another inventory space, like you said. honestly, it's nice to see a game that is, I don't know, essentially as the ones that I found. This is very, you know, old school, very Slenderman Penumbra.
Yeah, like it's unpretentious. Something. Okay, getting through things a bit quicker this time.
Seeing this is, I imagine how people with who still have like vinyls and stuff, like original vinyls, going, what you know about record players? What is this? Tripwires.
We need to get to the other side of this blockade, because that's how we find the rest of the electric switches.
Alright, do you dig through it with a brick? Yeah.
No.
I feel the plot's a bit meh, but the gameplay's fine.
Oh, no, I'm going to take this brick with me.
You're here for the story, are you? What this horror is games?
This is my security brick.
Your safety brick, yeah.
That switch looks on to me.
Yeah, of these the horror game genre, which stories actually stood out for you? They all seem very
Silent Hill 2.
To me. Damn it.
Silent Hill 2.
I needed to qualify my statement. I'm not going to do that to you. That's not fair. That's an actually good one.
Aha! This is the other side of the door that exploded. And now we know not to open it. Box clever, is he? Aha! Aha again! Clement. 1197. There's a temptation sometimes to go, let's walk all the way back to the save room before we continue.
Yeah.
But then you're like, how much longer it'll take to get back here? Is it worth the risk?
Yeah, if I feel. I play a lot of Metroidvanias that do that. So I could keep tracking on, but I should probably hit the save again.
Brick!
Well, I hate that YouTube has started sneaking adverts into live streams as well now. It's bad enough with the ads on demand videos. I feel you, Luis. You could get premium, you could get an ad blocker. I get you.
Look, we're all trying to make a living.
I do appreciate the super chats, otherwise I'll have to go back to dancing in the front room for money.
For who? For your mum.
Whoever shows up.
Lucky I brought this brick.
And now it's broken.
Don't mind me.
God, they're like the Dishonored rats, aren't they?
Oh, bugger. Hey, nice tasty rats for you.
I guess the Dark Souls rats too.
Crap. Crap.
Quick. Hide under the table. This massive table. So, first time seeing him. He can't see you.
I guess he can. I guess he saw me quite easily.
Oh yeah. He sees you. Sur le tableau.
Well, next time we'll be even more efficient. I've got to turn the light off. Whoops.
Does this count as a recursive element?
Just got to be more careful.
This is like Outer Wilds in a nutshell.
Oh, I need to turn the fucking generator on.
Yeah, absolutely, Hunter. Yeah, valio verga. Just to get around the demonetization on YouTube, I'm going to have to start teaching phrases to my coworkers. I don't think another language has that, like, worth. It was a cocksworth, essentially.
A cucksworth?
No, not a cuck, sorry. A cocksworth.
A cocksworth?
Yeah, that's how useless it was. It's worth a cock.
What is a cocksworth?
Not much.
Quite a lot if you're forming a rowing team.
Or you're trying to start a farm, who knows? Down we go to be more efficient. And it doesn't like move things around after death, does it?
It's just... No, it decides the placement of things when the game starts, I think. So it doesn't, you know. It's not scrambling everything on our way down to it.
God, I love this torch. It's like a little pocket lawnmower you gotta crank.
Okay, the super efficient version.
Yeah. It's a match your cock is worth, whether it's a rooster cock or one of the other ones. Yeah, it's like the way you guys say bollocks, but
if, forgot if it's about the fucking bollocks. Gas tripwire again. But it's all right, because we know exactly where we're going.
And, sorry, don't you own a gun? Yeah, does the gun even work against the thing?
Oh, yeah. I should probably have gotten it out. You can shoot him once, and that'll, like, dissuade him for a bit.
Just a little bit, okay.
Brick.
Is that flashlight historically accurate? Again, I don't know, but I want one.
It seems like the sort of thing that would be.
Alright.
I mean, as I said, wind-up flashlights are a thing.
Right, yeah. Apparently the real version doesn't last that long, though. They only worked for like 5 seconds. I mean, that's better than pitch black.
Wind-up radios as well. Oh, you did not hear me put that brick down. I refuse to believe it.
Did you barricade the door?
Yes. I'm not sure how much that would help, considering one of the holes he can pass through right here.
Jesus, my God. Hey, this is the deadliest gopher I've ever seen.
There's something in the darkness following me around.
Oh my God, that rat.
Yep, he's not liking what I'm up to.
What are those rats? Those are old PlayStation 1 rats.
Yeah. The lights flicker when the monster is nearby.
Oh, that's cool.
Something you learn from experience.
And a lot of horror movies, I guess.
Oh, God.
Oh, wow.
Bugger you. Where's my gun? Where's anything?
That's disorienting. Damn it, this isn't cinematic.
Yeah, you felt that one, didn't you?
Oh, well,
yeah, done. You better run. I think it takes more shots to dissuade him the more times you have to do that.
So he's like grown bullet immunity, is that it?
I think so, yeah.
So micro dosing him. Alright.
This is what we're after.
A barrel.
And we can't open it. Never mind.
Damn. Now we need to find one of the nice Frenchmen with a wrench. Sharp eye, you.
Tons of stuff.
I was just wondering something. How long have you been wearing glasses?
Me?
Yeah.
Since I was like 10 years old.
Why does your character not have any? Your ZP character.
Because it's a hard thing to bring across.
Fair. Oh,
they're going to make me shoot this lock off, aren't they? What a bunch of bastards.
Yeah, Marty's character has glasses. the one they made for me has glasses. Yeah.
World contacts for a period, but
right.
Eventually switched back to glasses. When I realised that, you know, I think it was after I met my current wife and realised she didn't really care.
Oh, you vain lad, you.
Yes, I thought. I was wearing contacts for a while, mainly out of vanity.
Okay. All right.
All right, guess we're doing this. Stall, stall, stall. Load, load, load. This is my last bullet, isn't it? Of course it is.
Fair point, yeah. Yahtzee ZP also doesn't have arms. How long has Yahtzee had those? I don't know.
I suppose I could grenade this room.
Yeah. Hopefully the monster's in there too.
I'm an idiot! Maybe he's still sleeping off the first bullet.
Mm-hmm. Hopefully he's not around.
Stop putting it away!
Oh boy. The oogity boogity's coming to get us.
Okay. There we go. Oh. I can't have that.
Well,
got too many rags. Yeah, there we go. Yeah.
And the gasoline was for the generator, yeah?
Yeah. All right. If I felt inclined, I might go and drop it in the tunnel that leads back to the generator. There's some more gasoline right there. Can't get away from the stuff. Oof. Oh, hello, Mr. Ratty. Are you late to the party?
Do you ever find out where the music's coming from?
It just seems to be like coming from a speaker on the wall.
Ugh.
For unclear reasons.
Only the French know.
Okay. I got the power working in the communications room. So we should be able to get what we came for and go.
Lovely. Alright, out we go.
At least I think it should all be ready to go.
Just awaiting the inevitable return of your landlord here.
Oh. Though I really thought that was going to be 0451 for a second.
Yeah. it's the number. It's that number. Can you get any gun flashlight upgrades? Yeah, is there any loot that drops? You know, varying colors?
There's no upgrading. You can get a shotgun later.
Dang.
Which probably would also work as a master key, thinking about it.
Yeah. Especially with the actual master key attachment.
All right, thank you, Joubert. Why don't you go back to chasing Jean Valjean?
As Devourer asking, Yahtzee, how's the pupper? How's Toffee? Like, well, you can't keep him in your clothes during
Toffee?
The summer.
How are you?
So you just woke me up.
He's sleepy, apparently.
How could you?
Since you ask. Don't walk on the keyboard, Toffee. You're not too big for a second castration.
For the auxiliary balls.
Wow, could lop his willy off.
Oh, no.
He's got plenty to spare. He's a well-endowed doggy.
Jesus, man.
Well, I am never going there again.
No.
Although worth remembering, there's like some fuel and rag right at the entrance to the soldiers' quarters.
Mm-hmm. Oh, he's coming. For us, you need to find the Les Mis fighting game Yahtzee mentioned and play it. There's a Les Mis fighting game.
There sure is. It's called Arm Joe. Oh, there was a... I found someone's dog tags... but that was on one of the saves where I died.
Tragic.
That might be the locker with the cigarette lighter in it. Oh, fuck it.
Wow, this thing is real.
Oh shit, he's coming back.
What the hell is this rabbit character? What?
Yeah, there's just a random rabbit character in it as well.
Okay, I should say. Yeah, see, I don't know the lore of Les Mis. Should I read the book first?
Or watch the musical?
Or that, yeah.
Dun, dun, dun. Okay, just gonna turn the generator off while I psych myself up for the next expedition.
Oh, hello, Ryan from Dublin, Ireland. Good day to you as well. Out of curiosity, whenever you die, you see quotations. Are they quotes relating to World War I and the horror of that period?
I never really pay attention. I'm usually just smacking myself in the face.
I'm just mashing A to continue.
Okay. Well, we got the code for the arsenal, so the next expedition will be to the arsenal to find the dynamite that we will be placing at the entrance to the bunker to blow it open.
Alrighty then. We'll get real guns now.
I don't know if we established this. This is the exit to the bunker. We have to stick some dynamite in there, and then we have to get hold of a detonator handle and stick it in there, and then we can leave. Simple as that.
Oh. Alright. Just that easy, eh?
Yes. Just two inventory items. Suppose it's taking me this long.
Yeah, just like my teacher saying, you got four problems, students, that's it. But it had a subsection A, B, C, and D.
I'm going to hang on to this meat.
Getting hung about here.
In case I need it. Okay. Chunky, 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 chunk.
Are there any settings you feel haven't been explored by the horror games yet? I feel like they're a little too consistent. Like, here's a bunker, here's a lighthouse, here's a psych ward.
Well, I suppose you could try setting a horror game in the place that's really nice and friendly. Like the setting for Teletubbies.
That's not nice and friendly. You seen that sun? That'd be horrible.
But it seems like such a cheerful sun.
God, like, what's in the tubby custard?
The tubbies that could not conform.
Tubby custard is tubbies.
Alright, to the arsenal for some gear. To get some arsenal gear, as it were.
The bunny graveyard set in a really nice meadow with a bunch of bunnies. I gotta give it to Five Nights at Freddy's, I guess. Chuck E. Cheese, that's a different setting.
Wasn't Showbiz Pizza like the first one? And Chuck E. Cheese sort of ripped it off?
No, whoever used it. There you go. Good old Charles Entertainment Cheese. All the kid horror games already do that. Yeah, because the scariest thing is children. There's nothing scarier.
Yeah.
A villain drinking milk.
That's why there's so many indie games about small children exploring scary worlds. Bugger.
What have you done? Oh.
It happened again. Fucking tripwires.
There's no way to set them off.
No, you can't defuse them.
Yeah, touch your body. Yeah.
There's a monster pissing about.
Have another one, a horror game where you're trying to avoid people talking to you. Once they talk to you, you can't get away from them. Kind of sounds like Assassin's Creed multiplayer. Thought it'd get us this time.
Bricky!
Baited you with a brick.
Uh-oh.
Oh.
Hey, have you met my friend? His name's Mr. Brick.
Oh, fuck. You gave him the brick. Oh, Jesus.
Aha. I lured him into the tripwire.
Did it work? I didn't think it would work. I don't know why.
Maybe he's smart enough not to walk into the tripwires. Maybe he's smarter than me.
Is he still there?
Well, the lights aren't flickering anymore, so I guess not.
Yeah, he paid the electric bill and ran. Oh. I'm just paranoid whenever the lights go. Woody's. The dude who eats pianos. $10.
What do you want? What do you two want?
I'm here for your brick. Where there's one, there's money.
What's your beef?
Jesus, man. These are New York rats.
It might actually be this beef that I'm carrying. Maybe that's their beef.
Wait, is that... is that what that's for? Oh, no. They want human. No. It's a little late.
Go on. There's your beef.
Back to the super chat. My toddler has a Western Front themed nursery. I've added barbed wire, sandbags, and a soundtrack of gunfire and screaming. But what else can I add to make this experience more authentic?
A really out of place football match.
During Christmas. I was thinking a trench. It's very common during the day.
Yeah, a trench sand pit.
Yeah. About 5 miles of no man's land.
Yay!
To the tunnels.
I'm not here. No bum cakes.
I feel like these tables don't actually work. Like, I don't think we're meant to hide.
Hiding under the tables hasn't really worked out for us, has it? Although it might this time.
Oh, it's working. Wow.
Oh, God.
Whew, I found the one table that worked.
Thanks, Mr. Table. You're a mensch.
A good one. Funny enough, with the whole, like, AI bad for video games, do you think this new machine learning would actually help horror games?
I don't think that's the kind of AI people are talking about when they talk about AI these days.
Ugh, I could dream. Like, ChatGPT is just the internet in single player mode. That's all it is. Is he still around? Oh, good.
I think he's buggered off at last.
Okay.
Oh, for God's sake, I jumped.
Did you break your... Oh, what? Okay.
I totally jumped.
So you got Fungus Finder asking, Minch. What is Minch?
A Minch, as in Ubermensch.
So it was German.
What was it? 464? Or was it 474? That was it. Come on, Mr. Brick. Time's a-wasting.
What's this? What mode are you playing on? There's different modes?
This is normal mode.
Oh. Well, what are the different modes?
I think there's a hard mode. Okay. I think there's a hardcore mode where it deletes your save every time you die. You know, for the real amnesia sweaties.
Yeah, as for the esports scene.
Yeah.
We should do that. We should host an escapist amnesia tournament.
We should form an amnesia esports team. From the staff. Well, if Outlast can put out a multiplayer game.
Yeah, right. I always did enjoy video game gauntlets. You don't see too many of those. The Rogue scene's trying to bring them back, where they just like, here, first one to finish these 5 games in one run, go.
You might think these wooden shelves seem a bit flimsy, and they are. You can't shove them out of the way, but something else can.
You can't hide in this locker because it's got holes in it. And shelves. What's this? SVS Guru 2000 with the €5. Have you heard of the lawyer using ChatGPT in a lawsuit and getting chewed out because the bot made up fake cases in its citations?
I have heard about that.
Yeah. Why you check your stuff? Or make up your own cases, I guess.
Oh, bugger, I think these rats are in the way. And me without my meat.
Me just here meatless.
Yeah, I was interested to see what would actually change when you play this game a second time, and so far I'm finding very little.
Mm. Just the positioning of certain objects, that's it.
Mainly just optional pickups and traps.
Right. Now, I know you have great respect for video games in the horror genre. You think that they're better than, you know, movies and whatnot. But do you actually like horror? Do you seek it out? Yeah.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Oh, God. I think I'm out of bullets, aren't I? Yes, I'm pretty sure I am.
Throw the pistol at him. No, you had
one.
No,
I had one left.
Jimmy's. Oh, crikey, man. Don't look at him.
Yeah, that probably didn't rub him up too well.
No. So he thinks of your iron.
Okay. We'll try to bring something to deal with those rats next time.
Yeah, what are these quotations? Looks like stories?
I didn't really pay attention.
I imagine they're just, like, either it's flavor text or it's actually, like, stuff taken from people's letters.
Oh, generator's on. Shit. Stop that. What do you think of games that try to have replay value in this sort of method?
Oh, in this method specifically?
Or just generally, just by, like, changing things around a bit.
I think it's a difficult, definitely a difficult thing to try and balance. And I would forgive a game if it wasn't replayable, so long as it was good. But I feel like trying to have replayability ends up mucking your systems more than if you hadn't tried. This is okay, I guess.
Yeah, I was thinking about it, and when I replay games, it's because I want to play that game again, and I don't really expect it to be different the second time.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
It doesn't really matter. Like, a lot of games have, like, difficulty modes, and hypothetically, if you play it the second time, you should turn the difficulty up. But I don't. If I replay a game, I'll just play it the same way I did the first time, because I want just experience it again.
I'll make it easier the second time around. I'll lower the difficulty, just because I'd rather... I think it also depends on the pacing. Like, if the pacing was kind of rough on the normal difficulty, I'd just put it on easy. But as far as replayability goes, the philosophy behind it for me is essentially, unless the game literally self-destructs after you've finished it, all games are replayable. And so
I'd say what makes a replayable game is just a game being fun to play and good.
Yeah, like, fun to play it again. That's why I both love Rogues and also detest where they're going, where essentially it's just like, yeah, it's different. It's not exactly replayable. Solitaire is replayable with that mindset. Just starts to feel the same after 10 runs.
See, the games I feel really aren't replayable are stuff like Obra Dinn, like detective stuff.
Yep.
Because you can't recreate the experience of figuring out a puzzle when the elements of the puzzle are fixed. Oh, I just wanted to get that one set of dog tags. Leave me alone. You're supposed to be hunting me in the arsenal, remember?
He is hunting your arse. Here he comes. Oh, boy.
Yeah, I'm not here, though, so I don't know why he'd be coming over here.
Amazing.
Okay, maybe I should have turned the lights on for this.
Yeah. Oh. Yeah, I need the internal sunshine machine. Yeah, most of my favorite games I cannot replay because they are very puzzle based or something or other. Where I'm just hoping that in due time I forget.
Boy, it's useful that items glow, isn't it?
In the dark.
There it is. 1197.
11, 9, 7.
That's what I wanted. I guess we can just quietly leave now.
See, in a sense, that's interesting you bring that up, because it's sort of like Skyrim. The people who really like Skyrim play different characters on it, whereas I ruin it for myself trying to do everything because I'm not doing this twice. Like, I'm not starting up another character. Same with Souls games.
Yeah, I watch skill runs of Souls games and think it might be fun to replay Dark Souls with like a rule, but then I'll replay Dark Souls and think, no, I just want the same experience I had before. I'll just be a dodge rolly dude with a sword.
Oh, that's how it goes. I can't make arbitrary rules because I don't listen to my own rule set.
Oh, go away.
Ross, what do you think of puzzle games like Braid and The Witness? Jonathan Blow himself? He's all right. It's all right. I think it was a very apt review where you said if you couldn't get enough of those cereal box puzzles, just, you know, play The Witness. And sometimes I am hankering a cereal box puzzle.
Yeah, I can't judge. I do the New York Times crossword most days.
Yeah, there you go.
Showing off my general knowledge and ability to solve anagrams very fast.
You just wish that there'd be a new Zodiac killer so you could prove that you could be with the best cryptologists.
I'm actually really good at counting the number of letters in a word in my head.
Right. And pray tell, when was the last time you made use of this superpower?
Well, it can be handy when you're doing crosswords.
Mm-hmm.
And doing the spelling bee puzzle on the New York Times app. Give me a word that's fairly long, but not ridiculously so.
Right. Like, say it, or what? Oh, yeah. Okay. Oh, ambidextrous.
12.
Chat, someone tell... Oh, I have to count them too now. Good on ya. Yeah. What can we do with that? How can I monetize that?
I've often wondered this.
Let's take this on the road.
Oh, God, which one was the way back? Okay, I think this is the way back.
It's probably anagram competitions. Yeah, I enjoy those.
Yeah, I could go on Countdown. That's an anagram competition.
Yeah, and you're from there. Well, sure, they'd be glad to have you.
Gargantuan 10. Fungus Finder. But it's a lot easier if you just show me the word.
Oh, God. SBS Guru 2000 with the 5 euros. Count this, yards. Oh my, it's Donadon Schiff Eiffel Schlagenschaft's Kapitan.
41.
No way. 1, 2, 3. Stop moving the chat. I think that was 41. What the hell?
You just counted in fives. That's what I did.
No, don't. That's what I did me, as if it's some just natural. No. I know you can't take a compliment, but still, that was very interesting. Oh, wow. Yeah, don't know what you can do with that, but that's a parlor trick, if I ever did see one.
It's actually not difficult.
Yeah, see.
It's elementary maths. I just split the word into groups of four or five in my head and then count the groups.
Okay, this is for people who can read and count. Does this superpower evolve from the fact that you do take, was it that you didn't finish school and you take that to heart?
Well, I'm self-conscious about my intelligence sometimes.
The lengths we'll go to just to prove that we didn't need college.
Okay, well, we got Clement's code, so we'll go to check his locker.
Yeah, if we're
marginally more prepared.
If we ever end up in a bar or something, we're gonna Rain Man. We're just gonna walk up to people and just say, "Hey, who can count these words the fastest?" That would be completely inconspicuous. No one would know why I'd set them up for that.
But imagine if you did that by yourself, and by chance I happened to be in that bar, and I'd like, "I'll take your challenge."
Oh no.
It'd be like one of them scenes from a shonen anime or something.
Yeah. Oh, it's not possible. How did he know?
Ah, here we are. Clement.
Is that a natural? Do you have a natural inclination to that, or was that just something that you've picked up over a long period of time of being very studious?
I have no idea. I can just. It's not just like letters in words. I can count most things very fast.
Right, you're a fast counter. That's strange. Very yeah. Nice though.
Like there's 5 diamonds along the top of that pattern.
Hmm. So I'll tell you what, he's just very watchful, he is.
Yes. There's 7 good. Steps.
See, I used to do that as a kid, be running up the stairs and like subconsciously just be counting them as I was going. But I never found a use for them, so I stopped. It's very Sherlockian of you. New Yahtzee lore unlocked. Yay, more useless superpowers. Go on, chat. Humble brag about your useless superpowers. Like mine would be, I can smell rain, but by 48 hours. In that way where even if the weatherman's going, it's going to be dry. I was like, no, I smell a storm coming in from the west.
Well,
don't do much for me.
There's that smell that smells like it's going to rain. I know that smell.
Yeah, that ozone.
Okay.
Good question. Do you count the landing on top as a step or no?
I think... I just count all the things that are a universal size.
Mm.
So the landing wouldn't count.
Oh, I bet you were a right bastard at those, like, that where they have jars full of jelly beans, and they're like, whoever gets closest to us wins a prize.
Don't think I ever entered one of those contests.
No, it's a very American thing.
Perhaps I should have done, yes.
Dang, yeah.
Well, that'd be really hard, because you'd have to factor in, like, volume and all of that.
Oh, it doesn't work in a 3D space?
Well, no.
Oh.
Well, I've never really tried. Okay, we're going to go to the Arsenal. And things will work out nicely this time.
Yeah, hopefully. Yeah. Fingers crossed, here we go. I believe you said something about this earlier, but I was in the kitchen at the moment. Is there any remakes you would want to see? Any games you'd like to see remade that you haven't already said?
I don't know. I don't have much truck with remaking as a concept.
Portal again.
See, that would only just take away from the magic of the original, if you ask me.
Oh, my tripwire, Jesus. That made me tense.
Shit!
Yeah, oh.
I keep forgetting! I'm just gonna drop this here so I can pick it up on the way back.
I'd love a good Thief remake. Nah, just go play the original. I've been doing that, and it holds up very well.
I'm glad to hear it. Playing Thief or Thief 2?
Thief, which one? What's the one that you recommended?
I would have recommended Thief 2 rather than starting with Thief 1.
There's no monsters.
Yeah. Thief 1 was full of monsters.
That's the one.
Oh, he's around here somewhere, I know it.
Hello! Oh, God.
Oh, turns out he was there.
That's creepy.
Okay. Lesson learned.
Yeah.
My superpower is I smell of a really hot monster in heat.
Yeah, I'm a very Bugs Bunny of you. The problem with remakes is they don't remake the bad ones. Yeah, yeah. Any, like, horrendous games I should give another go? I think Ride to Hell could be fixed, or was that lacking in principle?
Well, they're not going to do that, because they only remake stuff if it's got name recognition, and it's only got name recognition because it was good in the first place.
Oh, but what if it was such a train wreck that it has name recognition, like E.T. again?
Well, I suppose if you want to volunteer to remake E.T. for the Atari 2600, I doubt there will be many who would stand in your way.
I feel I couldn't do a worse job, let's have that.
Fair enough.
Knowing nothing, yeah. In that same way where people go, oh, they're remaking that? Why are they wasting their time? I think there actually could be a market for remaking horrible games, and people go, what? That piece of shit. Okay.
Well, everyone's full of ideas on how a bad game could have been fixed. Everyone with very poor ideas of project management.
See, I'd sell that. I'd rent out the licenses. I'd let them try. Do what Epic does with Paragon, where they give out
like
their assets.
Telltale Games, but for really bad things.
Yeah, very much.
Instead of like resurrecting dead adventure game franchises, you resurrect games that were bad.
Yeah, it's called that Game You Didn't Need Again Studios. Absolutely.
Or whatever the acronym for that would be. Ginder.
Yes. Just rolls off the uvula.
Alphonse, you should have put your code on your dog tag. You're useless to me.
Oh, man. The bunkers changed you. You were a joyous lad when you arrived.
Well, I keep getting eaten by a monster.
Fair, yeah. Well, that'd make anyone justifiably cranky.
Well, he certainly is.
Yeah.
Probably because he's been hanging around this bunker too long.
Was it Frost in the Ice? What games do you think deserve a sequel but never got one?
I would have liked a better sequel to the one Prototype got.
Right. See, I'm trying to think of a game that had a good one-off, but they didn't go again. You know, and they could have done more with the tech. I'm sure that.
My fucking hell. Cups runneth over.
Just give me like another Obra Dinn, honestly. Just keep doing that, just episodic.
Yeah, that's what I said.
That would be nice. Like, you could keep the same engine forever, the same style, just give me a different kind of puzzle each time. Yeah. Patterned Pike, $2. Ride to Hell Redemption, the 11%. Oh, God. Assassin's Creed Black Flag needs a sequel.
Man.
Against it.
I probably don't need to be so conservative with fuel as I am.
Probably not, no.
Trouble is, I could use it to make Molotovs, but without a lighter, I don't see the point. I was kind of assuming that I would get one earlier on a different run-through.
Right.
But apparently not. All right.
Very conservative with your resources, I see. Ooh, that tripwire.
Oh, go away, little rats.
Yeah, you always tell a lot about a man by how much underwear he packs for a 5-day trip.
Oh. It's the same thing happening again.
Oh, God. It's like we have amnesia. Keep doing this over and over again.
Yeah, what's that old definition of insanity?
Good old Vuja Day. We've never been here before.
Ha ha! Right in the bonce.
Good shot.
Ow! Fucking the rats!
Rat. Rats having a go.
Well, bugger!
Monsters and rats at the same time. Tragic.
I gotta say, this monster's starting to lose his mystique.
Yeah, I was gonna wonder, but I was gonna wait for you to like organically run out. Yeah, how do you feel about them constantly showing the monster? After a while, it's just, okay.
Well, this is where it starts to get annoying, I suppose.
Yeah, yeah. This is where I start to lose my patience with horror games.
I feel like that monster's spawned at that location twice in a row now.
Yeah.
I'm starting to think it might be scripted, and that's a little disappointing.
Because you always start these games going, oh, careful of the monster, and by the end you're like, oh, here comes that bastard.
Yeah. Well, that's probably an inevitability. One bullet. One fucking bullet.
You know what that one's for.
I guess we'll pack a grenade, just in case.
For your own head. Because you keep going near the rats, the sounds attract the monster. That's a theory.
Why, the rats are blocking the way.
Grenade them.
Oh, sure. That'll ensure I pass through unnoticed, won't it?
Yeah, it's like, how do you open Velcro in secret? Just scream as you're opening it. No one will hear the Velcro. once the monster turns into a game mechanic, it loses its mystique. And you realize that the horror game isn't that good of a game to begin with. It was just very, very tense.
Well, nice while it lasted.
At least that's
I'd
what
still
Outlast
say this game's worth at least one run through.
Yeah, for sure. I essentially don't finish my horror game plate, so to speak, but I still don't ever regret a purchase. Does that make me wasteful?
I forgot about this brick.
You've got the torch in one hand and a gun in the other. What's holding this brick up?
My giant French willy. Terror of all the whores of Paris.
This is where the inspiration came from for La Demoiselle d'Avignon. Yep. Famous Picasso painting.
Watch it, everyone. I've got a brick.
He's not afraid to use it. Anagram for Frost, a baritone surfs zit. Wait, what's the anagram? What's that anagram of?
Sebastian Ruiz, I assume.
Oh, that is my name. Well done. I've been going by Frost for so long, I forget I have a real name.
I hear that.
What do you mean? Yards is your name. Oh, God.
Ow! Brick, you have betrayed me for the last time.
I think you tripped it with your giant French willy.
I think you might be right. Oh, bloody hell. I'm just so tired.
Hell, leave me alone. I am just a tired Frenchman. Oh,
I'm dead.
Sweet sleep.
Okay, this time, don't trip any tripwires.
Right. The enemy is always listening. By St. Jules, who? Something. Nothing pleases me more than a Frenchman being gobbled up. It's found its market, I suppose.
Well, you'd probably enjoy the film Delicatessen in that case.
Mm.
One of the early Jean-Pierre Jeunet films. I just burned me alive. I deserve to die.
The sound of resignation. Amazing. It's a French post-apocalyptic black comedy film.
Huh. Yes, about cannibals. That was the joke.
I figured, yeah. Does that qualify as a food film? I might have to watch it.
I didn't realize food film was a thing now.
Nah, it's just my own thing. If that's a big part of the premise, I just like seeing how they make stories out of the food industry.
You must have enjoyed the menu.
No, actually, I detested the menu. It was a horrible thing. It's one of those, it's so bad it makes you grateful for the industry and therefore you enjoy it again, because the whole premise is essentially, what if Anthony Bourdain didn't exist? I was like, okay.
Hey, I'm making a mistake of carrying that brick around with me. I think I'll just smash open the map room with it.
There you go. It goes here. Fungus finder, $2. Speaking of crosswords, ever heard of a rebus?
Yeah, I know what a rebus is.
What is a rebus?
It's where they just represent a sentence with little pictures.
Oh, I love these. Yes.
Oh, fuck.
Gonna have to explain that menu Bourdain theory, what you call it, because at the start the guy is just like, oh, don't smoke because smoking ruins your palate and it's all about the pretentiousness of cooking. Meanwhile the other guy is like, I hate people like you and I've lost my passion, whereas Anthony Bourdain was like doing freaking heroin and smoking cigarettes and all these other things, and it's like, yeah, no bro, it's about the experience. So for a foodie to be that pretentious strikes me as odd. Anthony Bourdain would have to have not existed. So it's like a weird parallel universe. Keys of Not, €1. No, that's £1, sorry. Celebrate the first super chat from Keys of Not. Yeah, let's all celebrate.
Oh, leave me alone. Can't we live and let live?
This is World War I, my friend, no. Well, it's not the armistice either.
I just want to balance bricks on my willy in peace.
That's what got us into this situation.
God, I could smell his hairy armpits then.
It's immersive. Oh, I am indeed, Jimmy. Yep, season 2 of The Bear. It's a good time. It's not so much that the menu overplays the food. It's more so it's a horror film thriller based in a restaurant. They weren't really going for accuracy. I can give that. I can let that go.
Tripwire. Alphonse is unhelpful as usual. Well, if you're interested, we're trying to get around to the explosive storage area to pick up that dynamite. But obviously, we're going to have to take the most roundabout possible route.
Right. Well, goodness, which, this game is dark.
Now, that's a very alien isolation-y, thinking about it.
Well, they still haven't been hiding in lockers, though. It's a lot closer to the old Slenderman games.
The tables have been picking up the slack there.
A little bit, well. Can't carry any more items in your inventory.
Of course, when we finally get to the dynamite, we're going to have to sacrifice something that we're carrying for it.
The torch. You know, I'm sure someone could do a torchless run if things are only just slightly moving around.
Well, if you're a mad speedrunny type person, you just memorize the entire route.
Yeah. Mad speedrunners, horror genre nerds.
Okay, this time let's try to be smart about this. Mm-hmm. Let's play against type.
Okay. This is very unlike us.
Oh. That meat must be nicer than the meat I sent them.
I think you flung it a little too far. Well, plan B. Tripwire. Well.
I didn't have a plan B.
Grenade.
Fuck a bugger bum poo.
You're singing us a song there.
Oh, I'll sing you a song, all right. Oh, I'll sing you the song of my people.
Oh, I was expecting Celia. But... Well, what an awful time for the gas to go off. Just don't mind him in the corner nursing a grenade. Getting up the courage to toss it.
I think I'm getting mildly high.
If I was in this bunker, I think that's where I'd be at this point. Terrible way to go, sober. Keys if not. £2. Strangle me while I poo, but would amnesia VR work?
What a interesting turn of phrase.
I like it. Strangle me while I poo.
You probably have to work it into a newer engine.
Yeah, that's great. Yeah, yeah. Patted Pike, $5. Fun fact, the famous World War I Christmas truce inspired the highest rate of desertion of the whole war for both sides to be that year on that battlefield. Amazing. They were all shot at.
Hey! I'm still an idiot!
At least he's consistent. Oh, okay. Whoa. SVS Guru, 2000 with the €5. What would be the song of your people? Ding dong, the witch is dead?
Depends what you define as my people, I suppose.
I imagine your national anthem, what was it?
I like
God
to think,
Save the Queen?
I like to think Kickstart My Heart is the song of my people.
Considering it's been in the top charts for who knows how long, I think Mr. Brightside is the song of your people.
Well... I did feel a sudden, spontaneous urge to start singing it when you said that.
Oh, man. Look at that. It's genetic.
I don't know where the flip I am.
Yeah, that's a good game. Just got in. Mr. Lot, is Yahtzee playing it for the first time? This is his first time playing the second time.
Yeah. There you go.
Who are you yelling at? Fungus.
Hello. What's
here.
All this, then? Now this says to me, go this way, player.
My paranoid self thinks this is a trap.
It's all a trap.
Fair, yeah.
Playing this game at all was the trap.
Are you meant to do that?
I assume so.
Look, the first time I've seen you do something like that.
It's a try-anything game. That means you can stack crates.
That's fair. Try anything. Break doors down, stack things.
He's right there. Bike. He's just through that hole.
He wants it. Yeah. Who do you consider your people, Yats?
People who like video games that are like Silent Hill 2.
There you go. There's dozens of them.
Quietly close the door.
Quietly slam the door shut.
Hey, we made it.
Oh. Now to get this back to the safe room.
That's the sticking point, isn't it?
No.
Oh, goody. Some shells for the shotgun I don't have.
Throw it at him. Yep, Immersive Sim 101, when in doubt, stack crates. Yep.
There you go.
And always remember 0451.
Unless it's Zelda Tears the Kingdom.
Yep. I never played Silent Hill 2. Does it still hold up? Oh, just wait for Bluebird Team. Then give her a try.
Yeah, let us know how it goes. Because as I've said, my opinion on that will be useless. I am far too nostalgia blinded.
Yep, I'm holding on to my Silent Hill 2 virginity, so I can tell everyone else if it's shit or not.
Okay, let's. Well, I think our point is made. Let's just briskly walk home. Just have to get back over this thing. Do 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 do. Just going home by the usual route. Everything's fine. Don't need to be stopped by any authority figures.
No. I don't know if Marty's played Silent Hill 2. I haven't.
Shoot,
we could both go in blind.
La,
yeah,
la,
what
la,
ads,
la,
what
la,
ads
la.
Are you complaining about, Henry? Kind of my way. I get good ads. Not to stroke my own ego there, but I get the best ads on YouTube.
Only the best ads, believe me.
Yes.
Well, I don't know what the dude making noises are getting the knock on about. I'm just minding my own business. La 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 la.
No, gasoline, not needed.
No. No, I think I'm okay for that.
All right. Yeah, just carry a ladder, walk around with a safety vest on.
Yeah, just roll my sleeves up and hold a clipboard.
Oh, I'll let you go by, out of confusion.
Here's someone who shouldn't be stopped.
Nope.
Especially not now.
No, man's on a job.
Okay. And the good news is we never have to go down there again.
There you go. All my ads recently assume I'm a bald man with a faulty torture. Neither of those things are the case. Get someone else's ads.
But are you a man?
The faulty todger. I wish there was a way to have like an algorithm seed so you can just share it. Like, what do you get? Oh, I get puppy chow ads. Like, all right, cool. What's your code? Like Mario Maker.
There might be something to that. All right, we have completed 50% of the inventory puzzles in this game.
We did it. Now it took us 2 hours.
Now we just need the dynamite plunger. But before we get the dynamite plunger, we need to go into the ruins. Before we can get into the ruins, we need to find the bolt cutters. And before we can get the bolt cutters, we need to find the socket wrench. But once we've got that, it's all plain sailing.
I bet you'll have to play it for yourself, because that's it for us. You can ease up now. He can't hurt you yet.
I'm just going to go in here, quietly lock the door. Go in here, quietly lock the door.
Is there really no way to bring him in there?
No, he has never come in here. So I'm just going to... I think I'm just going to have a little sleepy. Eh? And never move again.
A little stress coma.
Well, thanks for watching the Post-CP stream, everyone. If you're interested in my review of Amnesia the Bunker... You can go to escapismagazine.com and watch it now, or you can come to YouTube and watch it a week from now. Or you can watch it on YouTube now if you're a premium member. Or YouTube's that thing that's like subscribing but a bit more.
What?
But you also have to pay some money.
Yeah, so many options. Get in there. Or just pirate it when it comes out. I don't know.
Thank you for the $2 fungus finder. Interesting that your name consists of 2 6-letter words, I've just noticed. Take my money for more fine content. Thanks.
Oh, what a shit pickup line.
Well, hello, my dear. I notice your name consists of 2 6-letter words.
Yep.
Would you like to insert another sixer in there somewhere?
Oh, take me now, you brainy man, you.
Well, I was Jatsy Crozier and I was joined by Frost.
Was I? We got anything else going on? Anything important?
I've got an extra punctuation dropping for everyone tomorrow.
Lovely, lovely.
I think are Jesse and KZ back later today?
Yeah, they are going to continue there or start Dante's Inferno.
Yeah, I think they're continuing with Dante, so there's that to look forward to. Otherwise, I guess I'll see you all next week.
Bye.
Bye.